Welcome to the 13th video session of the chapter Human Health and Disease. In this module, we will be learning about adolescence and drug alcohol abuse, effects of drug alcohol abuse, addiction, dependence, prevention and control. First, let's see about adolescence. Adolescence is the teenage years between 12 and 19 years, and it is considered as a transition stage from childhood to adulthood. At this period, they face both disorientation and discovery. And during this transition period, it can bring up issues of independence and self-identity. And many adolescents and their peers face a tough choice regarding schoolwork, drugs, alcohol, and their social life. And it is the phase of mental and psychological development of an individual. What are the reasons for drug abuse, or why do these adolescents get addicted to drugs at this age? It is because curiosity, need for adventure and excitement and experimentation. These factors motivate children to experiment. The first use of drugs or alcohol may be out of curiosity or to experiment its effect or its experience. And stress and pressures to excel in academics. That is a stress which can be given in their family, to excel in academics or sports or other fields. It plays a very significant role in persuading the youngsters to try alcohol and drugs to escape from facing problems. The perception among the drugs that it is cool to smoke, use drugs or alcohol is also a major cause for youth to start these habits. TV, movies, newspaper, internet, these social medias help to promote this perception. Unstable and unsupportive family structures and peer pressure is another important cause for drug abuse. Let's see what is addiction and dependence. Following the causes for drug and alcohol abuse: curiosity, need for adventure, excitement, experimentation, to get free from stress, unsupportive family structure. We have seen all these in detail, and these are the causes for drug and alcohol abuse. Let's see what is addiction. With repeated use of this drug or alcohol, the tolerance level of receptors, see, there are different receptors we studied during when we were studying about drugs, that is gastrointestinal receptors, CNS receptors, all these receptors, and this tolerance levels of these receptors in our body increases with repeated use, and consequently they respond only to higher doses of drug or alcohol. Initially the dose will be less, and as they keep on using it, the receptors dosage or the tolerance level of the receptors keeps on increasing. As a result, they can respond only to higher and higher doses of drug or alcohol, and this condition is called as addiction. Then what is dependence? If the regular dose of drugs and alcohol is discontinued very suddenly, the body manifests characteristics and unpleasant withdrawal symptoms, which can be anxiety, nausea, sweating, etc. That is, once a person is addicted to alcohol or drugs and it is discontinued, immediately it expresses itself in a large number of symptoms, and that condition is called as dependence. What are the effects? The immediate effect of alcohol is reckless behavior, vandalism and violence. Excess dose can lead to coma and even death due to cerebral hemorrhage, respiratory and heart failures. A combination of these drugs along with alcohol will lead to death. It's a fatal condition. And how can we understand if our children are addicted to some such drugs or alcohol? So there are certain signs. It is drop in academic performance, lack of interest in personal hygiene, withdrawal and isolation from family and friends, aggressive or rebellious behavior, lack of interest in hobbies, change in sleeping and eating habits, fluctuation in weight. If any of these signs are shown, we can have a signal that the child is addicted or he is under drug or alcohol abuse. When the drug is taken intravenously, this is another side effect. It can lead to infections like AIDS and hepatitis. Use of alcohol during adolescence can lead to heavy drinking in adulthood. That is, they just experiment it during adolescence. Later, they become a very great alcoholist when they enter into adulthood. Chronic use of drugs and alcohol damages the central nervous system and liver, and it causes cirrhosis in due to excessive use of alcohol. Cirrhosis of liver is caused. Some of the changes in females is masculinization, increased aggressiveness, mood swings, abnormal menstrual cycles, excessive hair growth on the face and body, enlargement in clitoris, that is their reproductive tract, deepening of voice. These are the changes which are seen in females due to misuse of anabolic steroids. Misuse of these steroids in males can cause aching, increased aggressiveness, depression, reduction in size of testicles, that is the testes, decreased sperm production, potential for kidney and liver dysfunction, premature baldness, enlargement of prostate glands, and enlargement of chest. These are the side effects which are caused in males and females. Last is how we can prevent and control it. First is to avoid undue peer pressure. See, adolescents or a child is usually given high pressure to perform beyond his capacity, whether it is in studies, sports or other activities. Such undue peer pressure can surely lead the child to get addicted to drugs or alcohol. So avoiding this will help us to prevent and control drug and alcohol abuse. Educating and counseling to face problems, stress, and to accept failure is another way. And the third way is to help to be rendered by parents and peers. And last is professional and medical help.